My name is Romesh Senewiratne and I'm an Australian doctor. I'm making this film to present some documents and information in support of the serious allegation made by the Kenyan Nobel Peace Prize winner Professor Wangari Maathai that the AIDS epidemic is the result of a genocidal plot against people of the Third World, and Africa in particular. The documents I'll be presenting have been collected in Melbourne in Australia and include annual reports of the main AIDS Research and Treatment Institute in Victoria, the Macfarlane Burnet Centre or Burnet Institute. In a previous film I presented some maps and articles from a 1988 Scientific American issue devoted to AIDS, in which blame for the epidemic was accorded to African green monkeys and the sexual habits of high-risk populations. In this film, I'll be focusing on the activities of the Burnet Institute and other organizations involved in advising third world governments on how to cope with the epidemic. The AIDS information provided by the Macfarlane Burnet Centre in this 1998 public health brochure argues that the virus that causes AIDS has been in Africa for perhaps hundreds, but not thousands of years, and that it is likely to have spread to the human population from monkeys. It also argues that AZT, or azithromycin, is the best treatment for asymptomatic HIV infection and AIDS itself. However, it says that this only causes a 2 to 3 year improvement in life expectancy. This 2 to 3 year improvement in life expectancy is strengthened statistically by the claim that the infection causes up to 100% of that HIV infection causes 100% of people to develop AIDS, and that once the HIV infection is developed, it's there for life. Now, in fact, there have been a number of people who have tested positive for HIV in the early stages of the epidemic, when the testing first became available, who have not progressed to developing AIDS to this day. And there are others who have previously tested positive who subsequently have tested negative. Of course, some of these could be false positives, indicating inaccuracy in the testing. This brochure strongly promotes the idea that people should be tested for HIV, even if they are well. This brochure is based on a speech given by the Institute Director, Professor John Mills, who came to Australia after working in the United States. He's a graduate of Harvard University. And he took over the Macfarlane Burnet Centre during the time that it was still the pathology department of the Fairfield Infectious Diseases Hospital and oversaw the change from being a infectious diseases laboratory to being a public health advisory organization that advise on AIDS prevention and other aspects of public health as well in over 20 countries in the Asia Pacific region and in Africa, and also in South Asia, including India and Sri Lanka. The brochure stigmatizes intravenous drug users as people who sell sex for money, and that these people should be blamed for the development and the spread of the AIDS epidemic. It also makes very pessimistic predictions about the spread of AIDS to Asia, and also a further worsening of the epidemic in Africa. It does not mention that John Mills, who is the institute director, or was the institute director at the time, was also the boss of the AMRED biotechnology company, and that AMRED were developing hepatitis E vaccine, hepatitis E screening tests, and also doing experimental trials with hepatitis B, along with developing an AIDS vaccine. It also does not mention, even though the annual report does, that John Mills was also a director of the Rothschilds Bioinvestment Fund. The Rothschilds being a Anglo-American Jewish company, banking company, that played a central role in the development of the eugenics movement, along with the Rockefeller Corporation, the Carnegie Corporation, and the Kellogg's Corporation. These organizations were also deeply involved with both the mining industry and the oil industry. This dates back to the 1800s, and Nathan Rothschild was also a Freemason. And the Rothschilds Corporation were central in funding the purchase of the Suez Canal shares by the British from the French, and also the funding of Cecil Rhodes's Diamond Empire in Southern Africa.
For centuries, the great minds thought that the earth was flat. Then the voyage of Magellan, it changed all that. As the colonists conquered for the aristocrats, a needy grew hungry while the greedy grew fat. So they sailed off to Africa in Voyager's boat, discovering slaves and discovering gold. The slaves were young and the slaves were old. Their mouths were inspected, then they were sold. The crimes of the West, behold. The crimes that the history books never told. When Masons built nations with deliberation and carefully drawn constitutions, but few people saw the solutions. They stare into space with military precision. They close the case with another decision. For centuries now, the prisoners picked with the poor. The aristocrats reigned while the slaves held the doors. The slaves manned the mines and minded the sheep. Some were well paid, they paid for their keep. They paid for their learning and they paid for their debt. They fought for the king and the country who ruled. They paid for their children and paid for their cars. They paid for their drinks and drank at the bars. They built themselves prisons, made movies of Mars. They looked with their radars away from the stars. But you don't expect trouble when you live in a bubble. They stare at the stocks and the market collapses. They name their new gadgets to sell at a price. They feed the masses propaganda and lies. The aristocrats now have computers and phones, proclaiming in language that's pure Anglophone. The masses go weary, and some they get stoned. And the parliament's joke is dry as a bone. But the slaves, they obey and they follow the rules. They pay all their taxes and pay for the schools. And now it's a corporate monster we see that robs our race of its humanity, that steals our zeal and our will to be free. We eat our meals and digest who we'll be.
Returning to the McFarlane Burnett Center, we'll have a look at the International Health Unit and its specific activities in the Third World. during the time of these annual reports, the International Health Unit and the McFarlane-Burnett Center were granted NGO status, or non-government organization, which allowed easy access to AusAid funds. AusAid is the Australian government's international aid fund. A central focus is on HIV/AIDS programming and the development of strategies for national responses to HIV/AIDS. The prevention, care, and support activities are focused on provision of condoms, needle exchange programs, and teaching that AZT and other antiretroviral drugs should be used not just in people with symptomatic AIDS, but also with asymptomatic HIV infection, and for the prevention of transmission of HIV from mothers to babies. The Burnett Institute are also extensively trialing hepatitis B vaccines, including comparing combined hepatitis B vaccines and separate hepatitis B vaccines. They are also involved in malaria control. This one is sponsored by Freeport Mining. In India, the Shalom project in Manipur and Mizoram were focusing on providing needle exchange programs, and the Burnett Institute was involved in setting up the first needle exchange programs in India as a way of stopping AIDS or preventing AIDS. However, in India, along with other parts of the third world, in what are known as pattern 2 responses or pattern 2 epidemiology of AIDS, AIDS is a heterosexual disease, and infects people who are neither drug users nor homosexuals. Reading the McFarlane-Burnett Center information, however, one would get the impression that the main reason that AIDS is spreading in the third world is due to injecting drug use. This hepatitis E trial is sponsored by SmithKline Beecham, a major vaccine producer. Coincidentally, almost all the SmithKline Beecham vaccines are produced again in Belgium by the company SB Biologicals. SmithKline Beecham also produce hepatitis B vaccines and a range of other vaccines. Tuberculosis, or TB, is a common problem in the third world, particularly in people with HIV and AIDS.